We're going to compare the Noctua NH-D12L to the Noctua NH-U12A CPU coolers. Before we begin, let's open up the packages. The slowed versions of the unboxing can be found in the description below. Next, let's look at some key metrics. Both CPU cooler images show the side of the cooler that would face the RAM. With that in mind, both CPU coolers do not extend far enough back that would cause issues with RAM clearance in most setups. However, they both extend out on the back side, which may cause clearance issues with micro motherboards. The D12L only has one fan, while the U12A has two, with both coolers using a version of the Noctua A12X25 fan. It is possible to add two additional fans to the D12L, but adding additional fans may cause clearance issues with either the RAM or the motherboard, depending on your setup. In regards to the radiator, the U12A has slightly smaller radiator size, with two more heat pipes when compared to the D12L. Both installation designs are very similar, and they are both easy to install. However, uninstalling the coolers can be challenging for both coolers if the thermal paste connects well to the CPU. This is due to the installation design not allowing you to slide the cooler off the CPU to help break the thermal paste seal. Next, let's dig into the performance. Note that these graphs are created by using machine learning models to help break down the performance using over a million data points in an open case. This means that performance may differ depending on your case's airflow and your CPU. To orient you to the graph, the left side shows temperatures corresponding to the solid lines, with the right side showing noise levels represented by the dashed lines. As a general rule, lower is always better for the data shown. With that in mind, we'll first look at the fan's performance on an idle CPU, which is assumed to be using 30 watts of power. When comparing the NH-D12L in red to the NH-U12A in blue, both coolers perform similarly at idle temperatures across the board. Given that neither fan is expected to go above 50% during idle, sound is not a consideration. As we increase the watts to 105, which is what the CPU is rated for, we see that the U12A has better cooling performance at lower RPM speeds. However, as the RPMs pick up, we see the differences shrink to minimal levels. When considering noise, both do not make noise above ambient levels until approximately 55% fan speed, where the D12L starts to run quieter. This is driven by the D12L only having one fan relative to the two fans on the U12A. When comparing sound relative to performance, the temperature differences are minor, with the D12L running at much quieter levels. Next, we'll look at the CPU overclocked to 125 watts. This shows that the coolers struggle at overclocked levels. Overall, both CPU coolers have similar cooling performance at idle temps. However, the U12A performs better as we increase the watts, making this cooler the winner for this comparison. And if you enjoyed this video, you should check out this one. Thank you for watching.